Birshut Morei Rabotai, with the permission of Hashem, this week we will be talking about the exit of Egypt. But before we talk about the exit of Egypt, there is few things that we have to understand. Yaakov Abinu, Alav Shalom, before he passed away, he called to all his children and he told them the only way, the only option you have in Egypt to resist the assimilation is to be united. If you are united, so you win. But if there is no united, so unfortunately, it will be a big problem. But Yaakov Abinu Alav Shalom, he gave them this advice only after he promotes Ephraim and Menashe. Ephraim and Menashe, they were normal people, the children of Yosef HaTzadik. And when Yaakov Abinu, he saw them, suddenly Yaakov Abinu decided to promote them, to give them a title. As you know, the children of Yaakov Abinu, we call them Shevatim, the tribe. We have Abraham, Yitzhak, Yaakov, and after the Shevatim. Shiftiyah Edut Israel. The Shevatim, from the Shevatim, all Am Israel, was the descent from the 12 Shevatim. Reuven, Shimon, Levi, Yehuda, Yitzchak, Zvulon. And then Yaakov Abinu, he promotes Ephraim and Menashe that they were the children of Yosef. The first question that we have, by doing what he did, every son of Yaakov, he can tell to Yaakov, Papa, why only the children of Yosef? Why, what about me? Like Yehuda. Yehuda is why he has children. He would tell his father, Papa, why you don't promise my children as well? So can you imagine, we will have 20 Shevatim. We will have 30 Shevatim. It's impossible. Why Yaakov Abinu choose only Ephraim and Menashe? Why? We have to know one thing. Ephraim and Menashe, when Yaakov Abinu give them he promotes them, and give them the title of to be like Reuven and Shimon. Can you imagine? Reuven and Shimon are the children of Yaakov Abinu. And Menashe and Ephraim, they are the children of Yosef. To put them together, equal, it's impossible. Reuven, Shimon, Levi, Yehuda, Issachar, they are Shevatim. It's like if you talk about a small man with a giant. I mean, a giant is a giant. Ephraim and Menashe, if you compare them to Reuven and Shimon, Reuven and Shimon are giant of Kedusha and holiness. So, I mean, Yaakov Abinu, how you put together Ephraim and Menashe at the same level like Reuven and Shimon? It's impossible. And besides this, all the Shevatim will be jealous. Again, jealousy. Again, Yaakov Abinu, you want to create a kind of jealousy. So why you did that? Now, besides all this, you know what he did, Yaakov? He told all his children, you know, from now, everyone should bless. When a father, a Jewish father, bless his children, he will bless them to be like Ephraim and Menashe. Wow, wow, wow. Again, Yaakov, before he died, it seemed that he wanted to create a kind of jealousy, a kind of something that inacceptable. It's like if I tell tell Moshe, my son, Moshe, when you bless your children, bless them to be like the children of Michael, his little son. It's impossible. It's not normal. So this is what we have to understand. That was in the parasha of Vayichi, the parasha of last week. And this is something that, of course, there is a message here. Yaakov Abinu, but we saw something incredible. We saw no objection. No one said nothing. It's like everybody accepted. Yehuda, that he was the king of the Shvatim, he said nothing. He didn't tell his father, why you do that? No. It's like everybody accepted. Everybody accepted the message. And what was really the message? How we accept the message? We accept the message this. A lot of times people, unfortunately, most of the war that you have today is because of kavod. Somebody told me 3 years ago when my daughter when Aryeh got married, somebody he looked at me and I told him shalom. He didn't answer me. Somebody from the community. He didn't answer me. So I said I said to myself, maybe he didn't recognize me. Maybe he was dreaming. I don't know. I didn't pay any attention. The second time again. And the third time again. So after I told him, do you have a problem with me? I don't have a problem with. He said, no. I said, no, don't tell me that. He said, well, I am upset. I said, why are you upset? He said, why you didn't invite me to the wedding of Ariel? I told him, because you invited this, not me. I told him, if I start to invite everybody, it's thousands of people. I mean, for that, you ignore me? For kavod? Are you crazy? For kavod? Judge me well. Maybe I forgot. So, it could happen that I forgot. Oh, besides this, do I have to invite thousands of people? I have to select? It's impossible to invite everybody. So, it was very important for Yaakov Abinu to teach his children not to search kavod, to be united, to be that Am Yisrael will be united. You need that love between everybody, and that was the experience that Yaakov Abinu did. What Yaakov Abinu did, he promoted two babies, the children of Yosef, Yaakov Abinu wanted to see if there will be any objection, if there will be somebody who will give a remark to Yaakov. And he saw that no one gave him a remark. Yaakov Abinu was so happy. I mean, it's impossible that nobody do a remark. I mean, Yehuda or Reuven, Shimon, they could do a remark. Papa, we're already 12 tribes. Why you want to put more? Papa, why you take those two children? Why not our children? Papa, why we have to bless our children to be like Menashe and Ephraim? No one said nothing. They accepted. So Yaakov Abinu, when he saw this, he said, if you carry on like that, Mashiach will come. This is the message of Yaakov Abinu. And this is the secret of Am Yisrael. The secret of Am Yisrael is being together, stick together. Each one should do the cover to the other one. And when there is Ahdut, so Hashem is the king. Berov Hadrat Am Melech. Bit Asef Rashi Am Yahad Shifti Israel. It's so important that between rabbis, the rabbis should be, each one should give kavod to the other one. When each one gives kavod to the other one, so the all Jewish people, they follow all the rabbis. But when the rabbis, they are between them, they fight between them, so all of Israel will be fighting between them. Each community, they will go only with their rabbi, they will criticize the other community. Don't forget, the Shvatim, there were 12 communities, you know? There were 12. The community of Reuben, the community of Shimon, the community of Yehuda. They were a big community, there are a few million people, you know? But Yaakov Abinu teach them, if each community respect the other one, so everybody is united, so Mashiach will come. But if there is problems between, so the God, why Beit HaMikdash was destroyed, the second Beit HaMikdash? Because Sinat Hina, because people didn't like each other, because there was problem, and because of this the Beit HaMikdash was destroyed, and because of this. But when look, sometimes, a lot of times, I looked at myself, that the bottom of my heart, sometimes I have a problem, big problem, to think Yaakov Abinu, he put Reuben and he put Reuben and Shimon, Ekel, two nephews, two small babies. Two nephews, they were old people, they were very, I think they were very, very old people, maybe they were, I don't know how they were, but anyway, to put them equal, like two small children, I mean, the Shvatim will not like it, but no one said nothing. Why no one said nothing? Because everyone realized something incredible. Everyone started to think, Ephraim and Menashe, they deserve the brachot, they deserve that they will be equal like us, they deserve a lot. Why? Because Ephraim and Menashe, they born in Egypt. There was no yeshiva in Egypt, no community in Egypt, no Yaakov Abinu, no uncles, nobody. They were tzaddikim. They were big tzaddikim. Understand, in Buenos Aires or in America, when Jewish people, like today, I was in New York, I was in Borough Park. What you see in Borough Park, you see Blei Anara, Hasidish, Jewish people everywhere. Understand, there it's easy for you to keep your identity. But one Jew to live in one country, that there is no kashrut, there is no Jew, there is no synagogue, no mikveh, nothing. And to be tzaddik, it's not easy. It's very, very, it's very, very hard. It's not easy. And that was the message of Yaakov. Yaakov, he told his children, thank you very much that you accepted my grandchildren to be equal like you. But I have to tell you, something that you don't know. That was the message of Yaakov. Ephraim and Menashe, it's very important to know that we are in Egypt. And Ephraim and Menashe, they were born in Egypt. All of you, you born with me. You were beside me. And you were beside Rachel, Leah, Bilhah, Zilpah. But Ephraim and Menashe, they had nobody. And with nobody, they were tzaddikim. So it's very important for you to know. Yaakov Abinu tell his children, it's very important for you to know that even if you are in exile, you can remain a tzaddik. It's up to you. It's up to you. It's up. How is your connection with Hashem? If you have a good connection with Hashem, wherever you are, you will be a good Jew. Like Ephraim Menashe. Because when Yaakov Abinu, before he passed away, the Bnei Israel, they were a little bit afraid. What's going to happen? Now, when Yaakov, he will die, we will be left alone. So Yaakov Abinu, he told them, you'll be left alone? Why you be left alone? There is Hashem. Hashem will never let you alone. Look, Ephraim Menashe. Look at Yosef. Yosef, he was the only one in Egypt. And Haman at Tzaddik. That means wherever you can be, if you are connected to Hashem, you have nothing to worry. But the connection of Hashem, it could be more stronger if there is united, if the Jewish people are united between them. The connection can be stronger and stronger and stronger. I would like to tell you something incredible. Last week, when I was in Chicago, there was a gentleman from Los Angeles. Every time I come to America, wherever I am, he comes to see me. So last week he came to see me in Chicago. So I told him, how's your grandmother? He has a grandmother, she's 96 years old. She's a Shoah survivor. She has the, you know, she's a, and Baruch Hashem, she saw miracles. She was a baby when some Polish people, that they're not Jews, they hide her. And after the war, that family, they took the girl to the Jewish community. And that lady, she has a suitcase, and the suitcase, there is there some clothes. She called the suitcase of Mashiach. The suitcase of Mashiach. There she had clothes that when Mashiach will come, she believed in Mashiach. She said, I saw already Mashiach. When I was hidden in the basement for 5 years. And every day I was waiting when Hashem will send me somebody to deliver me. And after the war, Baruch Hashem, I saw the light. So she believed, she said, I believe that Be'ezat Hashem Mashiach is going to come. So she prepared a suitcase. Like the Chafetz Chaim. The Chafetz Chaim as well. In Radin, he had a suitcase with some white clothes. He thought when Mashiach will come and there will be the Mikdash, so he will be a Kohen. He will have already the clothes to start working the Beit HaMikdash. Imuna. So that lady, she had big Imuna on Hashem, that Mashiach will come. So she prepared clothes. Now today, she is 96 years old. Today, she has Alzheimer. She's very old. She don't recognize her family. She don't recognize nobody. So I told him, so tell me what you wanted to tell me about her. He said, on Rosh Hashanah, he said, I went to the house to blow the shofar. And she stand up and she listened to the shofar. And then she told him, Avi, but you didn't do well the shofar. So she told him, repeat again the shofar. Repeat again the shofar. So he told her, Grandma, you remember? She told him, of course I remember. The shofar, I remember. After he blew the shofar, she did not recognize nobody again. again on Hanukkah. Hanukkah, he came to light the candles of Hanukkah. And she started to sing. הנרות הללו אנו מדליקים על הניסים ועל הפורקן ועל הגיבורות. And she was looking at the Hanukkah. All the 7 days, all the 8 days, she was singing the Hanukkah. Every time after the Hanukkah, she don't remember nothing. So he asked me, he told me, Rabbi David, how you understand this? She don't recognize me. She don't recognize her children. Sometimes she recognize, but the Hanukkah she recognize. And the shofar she recognize. Even when I did a mistake in the shofar, she corrected me. Hey, Abby, you did a mistake. How you explain this? So I told him, well, tell me. So he told me, you see, Rabbi David, when you love the Torah, when you love religion, you can, when your body is connected to Hashem, when your body is connected to the religion, you can forget everything. You can be disconnected from everything, but not from Hashem. Not from Hashem. From Hashem, never you can be disconnected. Never. Never. That was the idea of Yaakov Avinu. Yaakov Avinu told them, if you do kavod to each, you do kavod between you. You don't only do kavod to other people. Kavod to everybody. So be'ezrat Hashem, it's a good sign that you will have the zichut to see Mashiach. You'll be delivered from Egypt. The only one to be delivered from Egypt, to be connected to Hashem, and not only to Hashem. First, you have to be connected between you, all of you. Give kavod to each one. Give respect to each one of you. And when there is this, so, be'ezrat Hashem, it's a way of liberation. That was the idea that Yaakov Avinu told. I have to tell you this. The Rabbi Akiva said, the only mitzvah that can connect you to all the Torah, ve'ahavta le'recha kamocha. If you love people like you. No matter, old people, young people, that's it. This is so much. This is very important. You know what it is, Ahdut? Ahdut is that mean? Don't throw a Jew from your face. If a Jew comes to you, you have to receive him. Don't throw him. Yaakov Avinu said, don't do as you did to Yosef. Yosef, he came to see how you are, what you did. You took him, you sold him to be a slave. It's very important to be united. You know, we are not animals. There is some kind of animals that they take care of their children, of their babies, their cubs, till they grow. Once they grow, they throw them. They don't want them anymore. They don't want them in their territory. You know, animals, they have territory. So as long as the babies, animals, the cubs are small, the mother, she will risk her life to save them. But once they grow, the mother threw them. She don't want them. Or she ran away. She left them alone. Yaakov Avinu said to his children, that should not happen by you. You should not throw no one from your face. This is the secret. Now you understand, when Moshe Rabbeinu, alav ha-shalom, when he was born, And Moshe Rabbeinu, in the parasha of this week, he went to see his brothers. He was in the palace. Now, Vayitzeh el Ahav, he went to see how are they, his brothers. And he went. And he saw an Egyptian who was beating a Jew. So Moshe Rabbeinu punished him. He punished that Egyptian. The next day, Moshe Rabbeinu, he came again to help his brothers. And he saw two Jewish people fighting. And one, he was hurting the other one. And Moshe Rabbeinu told him, why you do that? Why you do that? And they answered him, you want to do to us as you did yesterday to the Egyptian? You want to punish us? Moshe Rabbeinu, you know what he said? Now I know the reason why you are slaves. I was asking myself, why you are slaves? Why? Why you suffer so much? Now I understand. Because there is no united. You are not united. You are not together. I would like to ask you one question. Why Moshe Rabbeinu did not know that before? Of course Moshe Rabbeinu knew that the Bnei Israel were not united. So why he said, now I know. What that mean? Now I know. It's like he didn't know before. Of course he knew before. I mean, what the meaning? Now I know. What the meaning? Now I know. Of course you know. The answer is Moshe Rabbeinu was a big tzaddik. He knew that between Jews, they are not united. But he didn't want to mention this from his mouth. He didn't want to talk Lashon Hara. Even that he knew, he didn't say it. When you love somebody, you have to keep, you know, as the Hasidut we say, never see the bad of your friend. You have to see the good of your friend. Never. Why you see only the bad? There is as well the good. Usually people, they only talk about the bad things. No, why you not talk about the good things? Talk about the good things. Moshe Rabbeinu Alav Shalom always was only talking the good things about Am Yisrael. He never said something. He never said the bad thing of the Am Yisrael. But now it's the reality. Now they told him, you want to hurt us as you hurt the Egyptian? We're going to go to Paro to tell him what you did to the Egyptian yesterday. That was Moshe Rabbeinu. Now I would like to ask you another question. Why Moshe Rabbeinu didn't punish them? Why Moshe Rabbeinu didn't punish those two Jews that they wanted to go to Paro to tell Paro what Moshe did to the Egyptian? Why didn't he punish them? So, if Moshe Rabbeinu would punish them, so he will not have to run away from Egypt. But Moshe Rabbeinu didn't punish them. You know why? Because he loved them. He was a kind of a person that even people that they hurt him, he would not hurt them. That is the Achdut. He preferred to go to exile for a lot of years outside Egypt and not to hurt those two Jews that they went to Paro and told Paro that he punished an Egyptian. That was Moshe Rabbeinu. And that's why Hashem chose Moshe Rabbeinu. Why Hashem chose Moshe Rabbeinu? Hashem chose Moshe Rabbeinu because Hashem saw that Moshe Rabbeinu, he was the real leader of the Am Yisrael. He loved them so much. He was a prince in the palace. What does he need to go to see workers, slaves? Why? Moshe Rabbeinu, he had a good heart. So now we understand the message of Yaakov Abinu. The message of Yaakov Abinu is, before he passed away, the message of Yaakov Abinu is, if we want to reduce feeling the sufferance in Egypt, being slave, if we are together, if we are united. And the Moshe Rabbeinu and Yaakov Rabbeinu Alav Shalom, it was very important for him that before he gave them that advice, he wanted to make an experience. What he did, he took Ephraim and Menashe. An example. He took them and he promoted them. And Baruch Hashem, no one said nothing. Then he told the Bnei Israel, bless your children to be blessed like Ephraim and Menashe. No one said nothing. Look, so what Yaakov Abinu did, he took Ephraim and Menashe, he kissed them, he gave them a hug, and no one said nothing. No one said nothing. So Yaakov Abinu was very happy. He said, I'm so happy, I'm so glad of you that I promised your nephews, Ephraim and Menashe, and no objection, no one said nothing. Well, he told them, this is the secret. If you want to be delivered and to feel less serious, less suffering in Egypt, if you carry on like that, be like that together. And before Yosef HaTzadik passed away, we saw something incredible. You know what? We saw something incredible. Yosef HaTzadik, he called his brothers, he told them, brothers, one day will come that it's going to come somebody, a Mashiach, is going to deliver you. Please, do me a favor. Before you leave Egypt, take my bones with you to Eretz Israel. The question is, why Yosef HaTzadik did not give that kind of will to his sons? He has Ephraim Menashe. Ephraim Menashe today, they've been promoted. Now they are Shvatim. Now they are tribed. Why don't ask them? Why ask his brothers? Yosef HaTzadik, he wanted to show to his brothers, even all what you did to me, I love you. I rely on you. I trust you. I mean, usually, when somebody wants to do a will, he don't tell the will to his brothers. He will tell the will to his sons. His sons, not the brothers. But Yosef HaTzadik Alav HaShalom, he wanted to lance, he wanted to give a message to his brothers. Forget the past. We are brothers now. We have to be together. I don't ask my sons to take my bones out from Egypt when the time comes. I ask you, your brothers. It's incredible, 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 incredible. Now I would like just to finish with a beautiful story that happened. Here in New York, yesterday, you know, I was receiving people yesterday, and I was very, very sad. Why? Because there was a couple who came to see me, and I was very sad, Bemet, I was very, very sad. And that couple, I know them from 30 years ago. 30 years ago. And unfortunately, I asked them, how's the children? So they told me the children, they don't come to us. They disconnect themselves from us. We have no relationship. We call them all the time. They don't want to call us. They don't want to have nothing to do with us. So I told them why. They said, well, at that time, we were not religious. But since we started to be religious, they left us. Because they don't want to be like us. They don't want. They don't want. They don't want. So I said to myself, this is the problem of today. This week, I remember, this week, when I was in the Ohel of the Rebbe, this week, I saw a small Dvar Torah that when Yaakov Avinu, he wanted to, when he saw that his sons, they were not with him, he told Yosef, Yosef, go and see how's your brothers. Now, Yosef at Tzadik, he knows that his brothers don't like him. They will kill him. Now, Yaakov Avinu, he knows that his sons, they don't like Yosef. So, the Rebbe asked a question, how did Yosef at Tzadik took a risk to go to see how are they his brothers? But it's risky. They may kill him. Why did he go? Why? And my question is, why Yaakov Abinu he sent Yosef? Yosef, the same question that the Rebbe asked about Yosef, me, I ask about Yaakov. Why Yaakov he sent Yosef? Yaakov Abinu knows that that his sons, they don't like Yosef. Maybe they kill him. The Rebbe gave a beautiful answer. He said, from here we understand how much Yosef respected his father. How much Yosef at Tzadik, he respected his father. His father told him, go and see how are your brothers. He goes. He don't, no objection. He didn't say no. This is Kibud Av V'Em. This is Kibud Av V'Em. My answer for the question why Yaakov he sent Yosef, why Yaakov was not worried that God forbid something would happen to Yosef with his sons. The answer is Yaakov Abinu Alav Shalom. He thought that the brothers, Chas v'chalila, that they can do something to their brothers, to Yosef. Chas v'chalila. He was sure that nothing would happen. He couldn't believe. They love each other. Okay, Yosef, he had dreams, but his brothers, they will not harm him. Now I understand the message. The message, now I understand. Before Yaakov Abinu passed away, Yaakov Abinu, he told them, children, I trusted you when I sent Yosef to see how are you. I thought that never you could do to him what you did to him. I did a mistake. So now, repair the mistake. Your success is being united. That is your success. Now you're going to stay in Egypt. In Egypt, it's a big country. A country maybe you will be assimilated. Maybe you will disappear. But the only way that you will not disappear and not be assimilated, always be united. And of course, we can be united only with the Torah. Without the Torah, wherever we went to Russia, we took the Sefer Torah with us. We went to Morocco, to America, Argentina, Brazil, Mexico. We went to Spain. We went to Portugal. We went to Africa, Middle East, always the Sefer Torah with us. It's the Sefer Torah will make us always united. Even in Egypt. In Egypt, they had no Torah yet. But what makes them united, what makes them united, they respected their clothes. They wear the same clothes. The names. We could recognize the Jewish people with the name, the clothes, the language, Hebrew. And besides this, stories. They used to talk stories of Abraham, Isaac, and Yaakov. And those stories is Torah. So Torah and Ahdut and united, that is a glue to be together. And that how the Bnei Israel, if the exit of Bnei Israel, it was only because of Ahdut. When they saw that because there was no Ahdut between them, they suffered a lot in Egypt, so they realized, now we have to be in Ahdut. Now we have to be united. And Baruch Hashem, the end was very, very good. So Be'ezat Hashem, Yeratzon, that Be'ezat Hashem, with the Zichut of all the Tzadikim, Abraham, Yitzhak, Yaakov, and Zichut of the Torah Kiddusha, HaKadosh Baruch Hu will send us Mashiach Tzidkenu, במהרה בימינו אמן כן.